Okay, so title of this lecture is One Dimensional Isentropic Flow Through Varying Cross Section Area Duct. Now, what is varying cross section area duct? So, it is basically a nozzle or diffuser. So, in this topic, we will try to understand the behavior of nozzle and diffuser. So, what happens when the compressible fluids like air, steam, or gas, when it flows through this nozzle or duct, how this nozzle and diffuser behaves, or what happens with the fluid properties of this compressible fluid. So that we will try to understand. Now, to understand the behavior of nozzle and diffuser, today I will explain four very fundamental and very important theories. Based on these theories, we can understand the behavior of nozzle and diffuser. So first theory, that is relation between area, velocity and pressure. So what happens if the area of nozzle or diffuser changes? What happens with the velocity and pressure? We know the function of nozzle is basically to increase the kinetic energy at the expense of pressure energy. So nozzle is used to increase the velocity, whereas diffuser, it converts kinetic energy into pressure energy. So it slows down the flow and it increases the pressure. So diffuser are used to increase the pressure, whereas nozzles are used to increase the velocity. So in order to perform, or in order to expect the right behavior from the nozzle or diffuser, you have to understand some insights into the physics. So this theory, the first theory, basically it relates between the area, velocity and pressure. So this is very important equation that we have to derive first. So that is dA by A plus dT by rho c square bracket 1 minus m square. So m basically represents the velocity, dT is change in pressure, dA is change in area. So what happens if the area changes and the pressure changes for particular velocity of the fluid, or say flow velocity? So Mach number represents the, we have three different types of flow, subsonic, supersonic and sonic flow. So how the nozzle and diffuser respond to sonic flow, subsonic flow and supersonic flow, that we can understand from this theory. Or say this theory is very important in order to decide or design the shape of nozzle and diffuser. So our second theory, that is related to our first theory, from this first theory we can design the shape of nozzle and diffuser. Now our common understanding of nozzle shape is basically this shape. So normally whenever we see this kind of shape, we understand that that is a nozzle, but that is not so. Okay, the nozzle can be of this shape or nozzle can be of this shape. Okay, this shape is basically called as a convergent shape, where the cross section area decreases in the direction of flow, and this cross section area is called as divergent cross section. So cross section area is increasing in the direction of flow. So this is a convergent cross section area, and this is divergent cross section area. We cannot call it as a nozzle, or we cannot call it as a diffuser. So that we can understand from this equation. Okay, if your flow is sonic, subsonic or supersonic, then what kind of shape can be of nozzle, or what kind of shape for the diffuser? So that insight we can understand if we can understand this equation. So this equation is very helpful in order to design the shape of nozzle and diffuser. Now third theory is condition for maximum mass flow. Okay, because we know that the nozzle is used to produce a thrust. With the help of nozzle only, we can send the rocket into the space, or we can fly the very heavy aircraft. So thrust is very important. So in thrust, the equation is m v2 minus v1. So here the velocity, the kinetic energy is very important. besides kinetic energy, the mass flow rate handled by the nozzle, that is also very important. So this mass also has to be maximum in order to get the maximum thrust. Okay. So the third theory, it is for condition for maximum mass flow rate. Okay, how we can achieve maximum mass flow rate through at the outlet of nozzle. So from this theory, we can say that for Mach number equal to 1, when the Mach number is equal to 1 at the throat, means when the fluid velocity becomes sonic velocity at the throat, then only we can get maximum mass flow rate. So if you design your nozzle in a right way, then at the throat means the minimum cross section area of nozzle. So at minimum cross section area of nozzle, always your flow should be sonic, means Mach number should be equal to 1. So under that condition only your nozzle can give maximum mass flow. And when your nozzle is delivering maximum mass flow rate, then your nozzle is called as a choking condition. So choking condition or choking behavior of the nozzle is when your Mach number is equal to 1 at the throat and when your nozzle is giving maximum mass flow rate. So that is basically a choking. And during this choking condition, when your nozzle is delivering maximum mass flow rate, whatever the fluid properties they are registered at the throat, they are called as a critical properties. So from this theory, we can understand what is choking, what is critical properties, okay? What is critical area. So that we will see in this theory. Now this fourth theory, that is effect of back pressure, that is PB, on behavior of nozzle or diffusion. So this is also very important theory, because if you have designed your nozzle, the shape of the nozzle in the right way, but if you do not maintain the design back pressure, if you do not maintain a specific back pressure, then also your nozzle will not act like a nozzle. That means the function of nozzle is to increase the velocity, but if you are not providing the design back pressure, if you are not set the back pressure is basically the pressure downstream of the nozzle. So if you do not provide the right amount of back pressure, then also your nozzle will not function well. That means it will not increase the velocity. Sometimes it may increase the pressure. So it may act like a diffuser if you are not providing the right amount of back pressure. Okay? And sometimes if your back pressure is not at your desired value, at the specific value, then there might be a shock which is occurring inside the nozzle, which is basically a loss of energy. So those kind of phenomena that we can understand in this theory, that is effect of back pressure on behavior of nozzle or diffuser. So this fourth theory are very important, and all four theories are related with each other in order to understand the behavior of nozzle and diffuser. Now in coming lecture, we will see all the theories one by one.